In this tutorial, I'll show you how to reveal text with light strokes. Let's get to it. Here we are in After Effects. I've already created a new composition. Now I'm going to select the type tool, click and type something. Then I'm going to switch back to the selection tool, increase the size of the text slightly, and align it to the center using the align tab. Then I'm going to right click on the text layer, go into create and select create masks from text. A new layer will be created called text outlines. We can now remove the actual text layer, select it, press delete. Then open effects and preset and search for stroke. It'll be under generate, add this to the text outlines. Then in effect controls, I'm going to set paint style to untransparent. I'm also going to toggle mask path visibility so we can see what's happening. Then set brush hardness to 100, brush size to 4 to make the stroke thicker. Then check all masks and uncheck stroke sequentially. Now make sure time indicator is at the start of the timeline. Then create a keyframe for end and set it to 0. Then go 2 seconds forward and set end to 100. That'll give us a simple stroke reveal. At this point, we can add a flare, and for this, we need a solid layer. Let's go up to layer, new solid, click OK. Then in effects and presets, search for lens flare. Then add this to the solid layer. Now we need to set the mode of this layer to screen. If you don't see the modes, colon, click toggle, switches on mode until you do, and set the solid layer's mode to screen. Now we can see the flare and the text. In effect controls, we don't really have many options. I'm just going to set flare brightness to 20% so it is not too bright. And I'm going to leave the lens type at default. Now select the text outlines layer and press M on the keyboard to see all masks that this layer has. And in this case, we have 5 letters, but we have 6 masks. That is because the letter O has 2 masks, the outer and the inner, since it has a hole in it. So that's also something to keep in mind. Now we need to duplicate the solid layer for every mask that we have here, except the first one, since we already have one layer. So I'm just going to select the solid layer and press Ctrl D 5 times to create 5 duplicates. Then I'm going to select all of the solid layers, all 6 of them. Then up here in the search box, I'm going to type flare center. And now we'll probably need some space, so I'm going to expand this up. Then I'm going to select the first layer's mask path and make sure the time indicator is at the start of the timeline. Then while this path is selected, press Ctrl C. Then select the first solid layer's flare center. Just make sure it's highlighted and press Ctrl V. And that will make the first flare follow the first layer's mask path. And we need to keep doing that for all of the masks that we have here. So select the next mask, Ctrl C. Select the next layer center, Ctrl V. And just keep doing that until you're done. And after you're done, you should have something like this. At this point, I want to make flares appear at the start and disappear at the end of the animation. So I'll move the time indicator to the start. Again, let's select all of the solid layers and press T on the keyboard for opacity. Create a keyframe for all of them and set the value to 0. Go 10 frames forward, set opacity to 100. And then let's go to 2 seconds and do the exact same thing. Let's set opacity to 0 at 2 seconds. Go back 10 frames and set this value to 100. So now the flares will appear at the start, and then they'll disappear at the end as the stroke is fully revealed. If you want to change the colors of the flares, you can simply search for hue and saturation in effects and presets. Add this to the any of the solids. Then in effect controls, play around with the master hue slider until you find the desired color. Then once you're done, select the hue and saturation, press Ctrl C. Select all other solids and press Ctrl V to paste the same color to those. Or you can also have different colors for individual flares. That is completely up to you. Also, if you want to change the speed of the animation, all you have to do is to select all layers, press U on a keyboard to see all of the keyframes, then drag and select all of them. Hold the Alt key on a keyboard, then click and drag on the furthest keyframe to the right, any of them, and then extend them to say 3 seconds. And now if we do the preview, we should have a lot slower animation. And that is how you reveal text with light strokes. Thank you guys for watching.